Hi, welcome back to this Learning Simplified series. Today we are going to speak about the science behind core banking performance testing or load testing. Core banking load testing, there is a lot of why, what, where, how, and when. So these questions, we are going to answer them in the subsequent slides. Why do we do load testing? How do we do it? Where do we execute it? What's the sequence of steps to be followed? So first, let's try to answer, when do we need load testing? So obviously, when there is a major CVS transformation, when you're moving from one vendor, say Temenos to FlexCube or Finacle to FlexCube or so on, so obviously there is a big change or a big jump, and that's the best time to do a load testing on the new system. Second, obviously, even though the vendor is unchanged, there is a major version which you are going to upgrade to. Obviously, that becomes the next obvious choice when we do a load testing. Third, when you're doing a mega merger with another bank. So recently we had Syndicate and Canara merging. So it's going to create a huge voluminous entity. So that's the opportune time to do a load testing. When you are going for an infrastructure upgrade. So for example, you're going from an IBM P7 to P9, or you're moving to a Oracle supercluster, then it's the best time to do a load test. And finally, last but not least, when you are anticipating a huge growth in volumes, maybe a huge surge in digital volumes because of the regulation change in that country. So that again gives you an opportunity to do a load test. So let's try to understand the various stages which is there in load test. So first and foremost, the foundation, which is the scope. The scope should be well defined. And what I mean by the scope is, what applications are under the purview of this load test? Is it only the core banking? Are you having the internet banking, mobile banking? What all applications comes under the scope? What are the volumes? What is going to be a benchmark? I'm going to speak more about it in the subsequent slide as this requires a lot of description. Whether the hardware is tuned or up to the mark for servicing the volumes which you have mentioned in point number two. What are the types of tests? There are three types of tests which you're going to see in the next slide. Are we going to have all the three or only one of them? What tools are going to be used? Whether it's the load testing tool, are you going to use LoadRunner? Are you going to use JMeter? What monitoring tools are going to use? I mean, based on the comfort of the vendor and the bank and based on the licensing implications, you're going to arrive at the tools which are going to be used. Second is the install, where we are actually installing the load testing tools, the monitoring tools. Obviously, the core banking system is going to be installed on a test bed. Then comes the preparation. That's an important one because here is where you actually create the test bed. Obviously, nobody is going to do a performance test on an empty database. You need to have some kind of data already populated, whether it's the accounting data, whether it's the customers' accounts. So you have to create a test bed, and of course you need to create the scripts for load testing, because these are the scripts which will be used for actually pumping in the volumes. And then the most important part, which is the execution part. Now the execution itself is the core to the load test. And if you see, this is going to be a cyclic one. It's going to be an iterative one. You prepare the data, you execute it, you monitor and report it, and if it is not within the benchmark, you are going to tune it further and then do the test all over again. So you are going to do it for all the three types of tests which is mentioned here, okay, if it's that's within the scope. And you are going to do it till you are within the benchmark or the expectation set by the bank. So this is the execute phase. And finally, you are going to document everything. You're going to report it and submit it for sign off. You'll also see in detail what this reporting entails. As I said, the volumes is the most important one because that's where you agree with the bank saying that, okay, these are the transactions which I'm going to do. So here I have listed, for example, 10 transactions. And the beauty of it is that you should choose it across channels. Okay, so here I've chosen across the UI, which is the front end, ISO, web service, PLSQL APIs, and I have done a good mix of transactions, channel transactions, channel query transactions, and so on. So these have to be carefully discussed with the bank. You can take the data from the existing legacy to see what are the top volumes, and based on the volumes, you decide on the number of users and the number of hourly volumes which you're going to test with. Now these do not have any users because these are actually channel transactions. And then the most important one is where you decide the benchmark. Okay, so this means that 95% of my transactions should fall within this range. So for example, the UI transaction 1, 95% of the transaction should be coming under 0.395 seconds. So that's the expectation set. And obviously it goes without saying that it comes with the base volume, as I mentioned. For example, in this case, my base volume is 500 branches, 30 million accounts, and an accounting of 1 billion. So on top of this foundation, the above test is going to happen. The other precondition is that when I'm doing the test, there should not be a failure more than 0.1%. And there are batch transactions. For example, end of day should be less than 2 hours, end of month should be less than 4 hours. So this is what has been cast in stone at the beginning of the project, and my test result should be equaling or even bettering this. So as I informed, there are three types of tests. One is the peak hourly volume test. So based on the average hourly volumes which the bank would have given you based on the past history, the hourly volumes, you try to increase it by 150% and see whether the system is stable. Endurance test, the same 150%, but the average hourly volumes, but you run it for 8 hours, because that's the typical business hours. 8 hours, you're going to see for 8 hours, the response time should be consistent. It should not droop. Some systems, what they happen, they have a very good response time and then it droops, but that's not what it should be. It should be pretty stable for 8 hours. Then the stress test, wherein you pump in X times the peak volumes and till the system breaks. So that actually gives you an idea what is the breakage or the break point of the system. So these are the three types of tests which you may perform. So how does the execution actually work? So these are the load testing servers. So here I've depicted 4, it could be lesser or more. So your test scripts are actually loaded into each of these 4, and you pump in the volumes through the load balancer, it goes to the middleware, and then finally into the DB database. So these 4 load testing servers are the ones which are pumping in the volumes into your application through a load balancer. So that's how a typical execution scenario looks like. And once the execution is done, over to the results. So till here, the left-hand side is what you had desired, and on the right-hand side is what you actually got. So out of 40,000, you actually pumped in 67, because it's not always possible you pump in the exact same volumes. Failures, yes, below the bar, very less. And you actually achieve 169% of the peak volumes, which is good. And the response time is 0.74. Your benchmark it set was 0.395. So it's actually good. So if you look at it, you actually exceeded the benchmark. Yes, there have been cases where you have overshot it. For example, I can say that here I've overshot it, here you've overshot it, and here you've overshot it. So that's not good enough. So you have to repeat the tests all over again till all of these are within the range. So you just should not repeat only for these 3, you should repeat for all of them. And all of these should be less than the benchmark which you have set. On the failure wise, yes, you are within the range. Test reports obviously will give the test results. What are the configurations you have done across the application, the database, and the middleware? What are the tuning changes you have implemented, because ultimately you have to implement it in production environment, and showcase all the results, because these are the evidences from your monitoring tools which you have used. I've given you a good understanding of how core banking load test works.